Well, it is Nikki. Welcome back to the channel, where today I am breaking down my list of books, TBRR, to be reread. I am a rereader, definitely. When I hear that some people can only like watch a movie or read a book once and then that is it for them, they can't relive it, I just don't get that. That does not compute for me. There's one series I can think of that I've read definitely 5 times and counting. There are certain phrases that I have memorized from books, not even like catchy quotes, just like random wordings of things from experiencing them so many times. It's like the never-ending gobstopper. It's a way of making the magic of a book just last and last and last. Thoughts on this? Are you a rereader, or do you prefer when you sit down to read a book for it to be something new and fresh that you haven't experienced before? For me, I actually don't read a lot of new stuff. I'm pretty picky when it comes to like experimenting with a new book. I like to stick to the tried and true. So for me, I have to be really confident that I'm gonna like a book in order to like invest the time. But I'm curious to hear what your thoughts are on that. Are you typically a rereader, or do you like new stuff, or are you a combo of both? Anyway, it stinks, but reading is pretty much the first pleasure activity to go down the tubes when things get busy. So like during school especially, the only reading I really do is the stuff that I have to do for school, which to be fair, is still a lot of reading, but in my opinion, it doesn't really count because it's not fun. I do have a list of TBRs, to be reads, but I don't have it written down anywhere. So when I do have time for reading, I tend to forget what books I had on my list to read, and so then I never get around to them, which is a terrible system that I definitely need to work on. But right now, I'm actually in the middle of Effie Joe Stock's Child of the Dragon Prophecy. And I will put Effie Joe Stock's Insta in the description below so that you can check her out. Seriously, the marketing ideas that she's had for this series and just the cool ways in which she's promoting her indie book is just so cool, so inspiring, especially for me having done it once before and thinking about doing it again, but obviously doing it better than I did it the first time. I'm really sort of taking notes of some of the really cool things that she's doing to market her book. So definitely check her out. Awesome stuff going on with her content. My goal was to finish this book by the end of the fall, and you can find that goal and other goals right here. I definitely know that I can finish it by the end of the fall, for sure. I just sort of had to put it on the back burner with school and everything. I just did not have time for pleasure reading. With the holidays just around the corner, I am excited to finish this book and review it. So Effie, do not worry. It is coming. Anywho, so there are a few new books that I would like to read eventually, but lately I've just been feeling the rereading vibes, as in like if Christmas break were 3 months long instead of 3 weeks, what incredible books would I reread? So prepare yourself for my TBRR, to be reread list. So first up, The Lunar Chronicles. So if you know me at all, this will not be a surprise to you. I've read this series so many times. I love it so much. Like sci-fi meets fairy tale retellings, come on. All her characters are great. There's sort of an ensemble cast of 8, technically 9 main characters. Every book sort of brings in a new sort of main character, but there is one overarching protagonist throughout the entire series. The characters are clearly trope-based, but they're all so vivid and just well-developed and lovable. One thing that I think she does really well is grouping characters in really unique and funny in different ways. Like, she doesn't just keep the love interest romantic pairs together. She doesn't just group the girls and the guys together. She's constantly mixing and matching this group of 8 or 9 characters, putting together like random pairings or random groupings, sending characters off to accomplish different tasks. And so you're always getting this sort of like unique batch of characters thrown together that have very, very different personalities and are not like romantically associated or even really friends necessarily. And it just creates this really awesome dynamic as they have to work together to get tasks done. Next up, Brandon Sanderson's Stormlight Archive, specifically books 1 and 2. So books 1 and 2, called The Way of Kings and Words of Radiance, were actually somewhat life-changing for me with regards to my writing adventure. They really sort of showed me what my vision for my fantasy project looks like practically played out. I had already self-published one book before I actually read these, finally read them, and once I did, it was just so exciting as I was reading this book and just seeing sort of my own ideas playing out and recognizing like, this is my vision. This is what I've been trying to capture in my book And this is what he's capturing in his. It was very validating to know that, like, my vision was something that actually has a place out there, that it's something that is being done. It's not just some sort of impossible, convoluted idea that I have in my head. So reading these books was almost like a reinforcement of that vision and a reinforcement of what I wanted to bring to my readers, because I'm reading this book thinking, like, this is exactly what I want. Like, the author is just giving me exactly what I want and what I want to give to my readers. It was just very exciting and also just very educational. I learned so much from this series. I believe I read somewhere from the author that he spent up to like 10 years just prepping for this story, working on the world and building this universe, which on one hand is like, but on the other hand, I actually find pretty encouraging because it reminds me that there's not a rush. I would rather take the time, even if it's 10 years, to make an absolutely awesome world, like the world in the Stormlight Archive, than rush and have like a subpar world and story. And one more thing, I feel like it just gave the term epic like entirely new meaning, especially books 1 and 2. 3 and 4 were also highly addictive, and I really cannot wait for book 5, although I'm also kind of stressed for book 5 because of the killer foreshadowing that was happening at the end of book 4. But books 1 and 2 especially really helped me to sort of pin down what the term epic fantasy actually means. Heartless. This is another one by Marissa Meyer that I really, really enjoyed, and I wouldn't put it on the same level as the Lunar Chronicles necessarily, but it's another fairy tale retelling. I'm really feeling the fairy tale retellings right now, and I've actually been wanting to reread it again. And no, reread again is not redundant because I've already reread it once. I think she does fairy tales really, really well. Speaking of retellings, side note, if you are into that, I would highly recommend, what is her name? I would highly recommend Shannon Hale's Books of Bairn because they were just so sweet and clean and well-written and just beautiful and unique. Like, just a great, great, clean series. Charles Dickens' A Tale of Two Cities. This one I read in grade 10, y'all, and it made such an impression. I absolutely fell in love with this story. I think it was the first Dickens story I ever read, and after that, I just absolutely loved his writing and loved his stories. I remember, I think it was on the way to like a church function, I was reading this book. I might have been even crying, just getting so emotional, and I had to like get a hold of myself so that I could focus on what's actually important, like church. Point being, there is a reason that this is such like a well-known classic, and it's been years since I read it last, so I'm missing my favorite character, and if I had time this holiday, I would really, really love to relive this classic. The Space Trilogy by C.S. Lewis. Let's take a moment to admire how cool this cover is. This book was one that I read a little while back. It's a trilogy, and it is by C.S. Lewis, who is one of my absolute favorite authors of all time, maybe even my favorite author of all time. It's like sci-fi, but has like elements of Arthurian mythology going on at the same time. Plus, obviously, because it's C.S. Lewis, you have like spiritual aspects, a little bit of allegory in there, just a really cool combo of ideas. I know that I got a lot of sort of spiritual insight out of it the first time that I read it, but again, that was a while ago, and I think that having read even more of his stuff since then, like Mere Christianity, The Problem of Pain, Miracles, I think that I might get even more out of it this time, even more spiritual insight. But books like that are just so exciting that you can read again and again, and God can use them every time you read them to speak to you in different ways or to teach you new things or inspire you to serve him in new ways. That, I think, is what makes a book like truly, truly powerful, is when God can use it in that way. And speaking of which, last on my list, but certainly not least, the Bible. Like, yeah, talk about books that God can use to like speak to you in new ways every time you read it. Seriously. I've read through the Bible a couple times cover to cover already, but this past year I've been doing more like sectional readings. So I feel like maybe in the new year I might try another like read your Bible in a year plan, read it from cover to cover again. And again, you want to talk about a book being alive, like that is the Bible. It's just new and fresh every time. God can speak to you differently through it every single time you read it. It's a living book, which just makes it so exciting, and that's why it belongs at the top of my stack. So that is my TBRR. Do I think that I'm going to get through all of these over the holidays? No, absolutely not. I will be very lucky if I get through one. But a girl can dream. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. What are you wanting to reread over the holidays? Do you have something that is on your TBRR list that I should know about? Drop them in the comments below. Feel free to like and subscribe if you enjoy this video or you like content like this. As always, feel free to suggest ideas in the comments below. And of course, do not forget to spend some time in the clouds today.